Last episode, I took some time to talk about how shareware allowed smaller game developers to still get their games published. Because the games were only brief demos, a publisher could pack a lot of games into a small supply of floppy disks, and since there were so many of them for the consumer to choose from and try out, it reduced the risk for the publisher, who is now practically free from the concern of sinking a ton of money into a single game that bombs. As a result, they can thusly charge each individual developer much less to see their game published. Additionally, if the demo is actually good, or at least better than the rest it came with, then the consumer is likely to order the full version, which means that the good game developers are more likely to see a profitable return for their investment. This was a huge step up from the way things were run before, where all you had to go on was box art. Word Rescue is a good example of a game created by a small development company that probably didn't have the funds to get their game published on their own, but shareware allowed for it. This game was developed by Redwood Games and published by Apogee Software in 1992. After some brief opening credits, the game opens to an odd-looking title screen involving a giant green worm wielding an umbrella and sporting some glasses from the 70s? As well as a couple of children in the phrase Word Rescue, written in icky slime. The significance of all of these things will be revealed shortly as we move on to the story, which will surely be an epic tale of love and loss. And rescuing words, of course. The story. The mean old Gruzzles can't read, and they don't want anyone else to be able to read. They are stealing the words out of all the books. Benny Bookworm needs your help to stop the Gruzzles. He needs you to reunite the words with their meanings. Once you join all the words with their pictures, Benny will magically put them back into the books. Then, Benny will reveal a key that will open the door to the next level, but you must find the door. Benny is your friend, and he will protect you. But... stay away from the Gruzzles. If they catch you, they will take any words you have. If you get close to a Gruzzle, point him out to Benny by pressing the space bar. Benny will slime him for you, and then no problem. Be careful, Benny only has a few buckets of slime. Each time you make a mistake and try to join the wrong picture with a word, a new Gruzzle will appear. Alright, well, that was hardly the Shakespearean novel I was expecting. I'll be sure to give Redwood Games a nasty letter and an angry and bold red font later. But it did provide some small amount of much-needed exposition, so whatever, let's start the first level. Welcome to Gruzzleville. So, to fill in the gaps where the story left off, you've got four objectives in every level. There are three side objectives and one main one. The main objective is to jump up and hit a random question mark block, this sounds familiar, and then find the block with the corresponding picture and touch that. Do that with every question mark block and you get the key to move on to the next level. Now for the three side objectives. These are supposed to be completed in a certain order. Around the level are books, which each give points as you collect them. After you've collected enough of them, one of the question mark block words will appear in the box at the bottom of the screen.
that's the word you need to know to finish the second objective. Aside from the books, there are also letters scattered around the level. The letters correspond to the word you reveal when you collect enough books. If you collect all of the letters in the correct order, then you get some more bonus points. The final side objective is to collect all of the books instead of just some of them. If you collect every last book in the level, then you get some additional bonus points. Now, that alone would seem like enough to do, but to add another layer of difficulty are the Gruzzles.
I can't believe I'm saying this out loud, but they cheat. That's what they do. The Gruzzles, they cheat.
And no matter what you do, you can't get around them. They will touch you, and then you will die, and then you'll start the whole level all over again. You have to slime them, which is easy, right? Just point your guy in their direction and hit the space bar, simple enough. But if you get killed even once, you're boned, buddy, because the game doesn't even have the common courtesy to let you restart the level with a default amount of slime. Nope, you restart the level with the exact amount of slime you died with. Bull crap. That means that if you spend all your slime trying to live and die anyway, you start the next level with no slime and are more prone to a pounding than a fat kid playing dodgeball in a wheelchair!
Okay, just relax, Grue. You're the bigger man, just let it go.
When forced to deal with the Gruzzles without any slime, which will occur sooner or later, you'll eventually figure out, after a dozen deaths or so, that time for them completely stops if they're outside of your screen. Sometimes you want to lead a Gruzzle over to a pitfall, since it's the only way to get rid of them without slime, but as soon as they leave your screen, they stop following you. They actually stop moving altogether. You have to go back and bring them back into your screen in order to get them to follow you again. That's right, time stops for anything more than 15 feet away from you. I mean, I know this is a side-scroller, but can you imagine how that actually looks from a first-person perspective? For a game that attempts to tout itself as an educational title, it sure does make you spend a lot of time trying to figure out the Gruzzles' AI. And on top of the BS that keeps you from jumping over them, they will also occasionally rain from the sky. Yeah, what the heck is this? As it turns out, they fall from the sky only in specific areas, so you have to die in all of those places to those specific Gruzzles first enough times to figure out that it's always in the same place with each skydiving Gruzzle, and then enough times again to memorize all the places and kill all of the reigning monstrosities in one man, and then do it all over again next level! You know, it's awfully hard to learn the definitions of all of these new words when you keep killing me every 5 seconds, game! I guess this is what I get for playing on the hard difficulty aimed only at children 10 and up. Wait. 10 and up?!
Alright then. It's time to take off the kitty gloves. And it's time
to rescue some words.
Try to be best, cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you gotta hang tough to make it. History repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. No.
since I changed the